The Xtreme Walleye Angler is presented by Go Fish in Ontario, It's Catching. Our trip to Red Pine Lodge was met with cool temperatures and a mix of rain with sunny breaks. We hooked up with local angler Connor Dunn, who has lived on the lake for many years and has a lot of knowledge catching walleye from this lake and the river system. Connor suggested we start at the mouth of the Ivanhoe River, fishing with small jigs and live bait, looking for post-spawn fish dropping back to the main lake.
What do you think? More towards the center?
Yeah, so then we can just pitch out either side.
Okay. Go for it, Connor. First cast. The real first cast. Ivanhoe River. Looking for shore lunch eaters, man.
Yeah.
This is such a simple way to fish. A little ball head jig, and I got it in a perch pattern, you know, with the orange, some black, and chartreuse, a big eye, and that's a quarter ounce. We're fishing anywhere from about, 6 feet to about 10, and it's off that sandbar. Connor had that area where the creek comes out. There's current coming down, so it's just a classic walleye spot. So just those little underhand pitches, letting it settle, and no erratic jerks, movements, not snapping it, just like little lift and drop. All I want them to do is see that bright colored little jig, see the worm, see the minnow, and then eat it.
Oh, there we go.
Right there.
There we go, fish on.
Atta boy, look at that, eh? Local, of course. How's he feel?
Feels nice, actually.
Does he?
If it's a pickerel, it's a nice one.
Atta boy, got it.
Yeah.
Is that we're gonna start at Red Pine?
Yeah. Oh, that's a nice walleye.
Oh, dude.
It's a nice walleye.
Look at you go,
that's
eh?
The one we wanted. Yes.
Nice. Atta boy. So
there
that's,
we go.
You think under 18?
Yeah, I think he's about 17, 16 and a half.
Here we are from Red Pine Lodge in Foleyet.
First
right?
cast.
First cast. I think it should be a good day.
Yeah, I think so.
So you're allowed four under 18.
Four under 18.
Or three under 18 and one.
One over.
Gotcha. So that's a pretty good start, huh?
There we go.
Yeah, man. He's a boxer, isn't he?
Yeah, I think so.
Look, we got him two textbooks.
Look at that. Yeah, he wasn't getting off.
Oh, man, oh,
yeah.
Man. What a start, dude.
Yeah.
Cool. We're already putting fish in the live well on the first cast.
Yeah.
Now, you saw it live, man. There's no funny business here. The only funny business is him catching fish right away. Minnow, I think you've sacrificed it to the fish gods, right?
Yes. Yes.
On how can you beat it? First cast, Connor, on the edge of that sandbar, pow, 17 and a quarter inch fish. Now, am I sold on this place?
You bet.
You know yourself, river situation, there's always moving
oh,
fish.
Yes, yes, always. Yes.
So even if you pull fish out an hour earlier,
uh-huh.
new fish move in if it's a feeding area, right? The lake sometimes, you know, you pound the shoal.
Yeah, yeah.
Gotta wait again,
yeah,
right?
Yeah.
See, that was fate, first cast.
Yeah, that was nice.
Like a bump too.
Yeah.
There's the edge.
There's the edge, look at that.
There's the dark spot.
Yeah.
Right up front.
Yeah.
Fish. Look at that, right below the boat, dude.
Right there?
Look at that.
Oh, nice.
That's a whole mess.
Nice.
That was bait fish, and that was a weed.
Oh, I just got a bite,
that was
too.
A fish, too, dude.
I just got a hit.
I lost it. There it is.
Oh, there you go. There you go.
And nice walleye, I think. Yeah, man.
Nice walleye.
Yeah, look at that. My first walleye.
Nice walleye.
Oh, he's a nice one. That looks really good, dude.
He's a nice one.
Yeah, man.
Oh,
ooh,
yeah.
Look at that.
Oh, yeah.
Chunky, eh?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, wow.
Oh, there's a beauty.
Man, they have nice chunks here,
yeah.
Eh? Wow.
Yeah, yeah.
I'd say, man. Oh, yeah, sir.
Look at him.
Nice and warm, too.
Yes.
Oh, oh,
right,
good thing you got
the
net.
There you go. Yeah. Yeah.
So we're getting him on minnows and worms. Hold
yeah.
on, fish. He knows where he's going, that's why, right?
Yeah.
He's like, uh-oh.
Yeah, that's a nice
there
fish.
There it is.
There's a nice fish.
Red Pine Lodge.
Yeah.
This is the Ivanhoe River.
Ivanhoe River.
Yeah, man. Beautiful
yeah.
looking fish.
Yeah, that's a
oh,
nice
wow.
fish. Yeah.
Maybe we'll taste him later?
Maybe, yeah.
Okay. I'll put him in the box, my friend. He's under 18. You want to measure him just for...
Yes, yes.
Okay. Okay, let's make sure he's exactly what he should be. He is. Look to the tip of the tail. 17 and 3 and 7 eighths.
Perfect.
So guess what happens to him?
Yeah.
You become our meal. Let's put him in the box. Man, they fight nice too.
Yes, they dog, eh?
Right on, Connor. So yeah. How long have you been actually living up here? Your whole life?
My whole life, yeah.
Nice, eh?
Yeah. Wow. Third generation on the lake.
Wow,
yeah.
Eh?
Yeah.
And all walleyes, huh?
And pike? Walleye, pike, perch, yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
And how far does it go? All the way into like October you can catch them too?
Oh, as long as, some of the best fishing is in the fall too.
Wow.
Yeah. Right until the end of October sometimes.
Maybe
yeah.
I'll be back in October.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay, let's regroup and get some more, eh?
Yeah.
Right on, man. Okay, go for it, Connor. Now I can really focus, right? No foot on the trolling motor, and
boom.
He's got one ready. Size?
Nah, just a nice eater, I think.
You let me know if you want to eat the net.
No, I think I should be able to lift him in. What do you think?
Releaser?
Yeah, yeah. I think so.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I got faith in you.
Yeah.
Nice.
There you go.
Here's exactly what we did. We got the sandbar pointing out here from this creek and stuff like too. Instead of always fighting the trolling motor and a little bit of current, we came on to the very tip where the sandbar goes down, put the power poles down so we can just fish like we're on a dock. Like you talk about, oh, they really need them. You can do it by anchor and stuff too from a boat from the lodge, but I've got them on my boat. I brought my boat here. So by positioning it there, we know we caught fish in this area. Just stay back, cast and catch like you just did.
Mm-hmm.
So let's just keep doing it. Now, what is the appeal of the lodges, really? Like Red Pine Lodge here, and it's just, I don't know, it's hard to put into words. You gotta come here and experience Ontario lodges. There's so much fun, you know, you and your buddies and stuff like that, and you're probably watching the show and it's cold outside and you think about, you know what, this summer or this spring, let's book a trip. Let's get out there to Ontario, the wilderness, have a shore lunch, catch some walleyes and perch and different pike and different stuff. But I mean, it's the whole ambiance. The fishing, yes, it can be good, it can be great, but it's just a piece of it. All about having meals, camaraderie, making memories with you and the ones you love, your friends and family. That's why I come to lodges. That's why you should consider it too. Because right here in beautiful Ontario, we've got it for you so you can have the time of your life. You know, if I had my choice to fish walleye in bright sun, I'd fish a river more than a lake. Because a river of moving fish, you know, that's just, it's not biased because we're in a river, but
yeah,
I mean,
yeah.
I'd much rather a river because they move a lot more.
The sun doesn't affect them as much?
Yeah, that's what I found. When I'm fishing a lake, I'll have to really dissect them real tight to weed or in the pockets or go deeper.
Deep, yeah.
But this time of year, especially in this river like this, a lot of wandering fish, right?
Yeah, in the lake, it's mostly weeds and deep.
Right.
In the summertime.
Gotcha.
There we
go.
And
that is, nope, smaller one.
Smaller one?
Yeah, I don't think he's...
He's a small one.
Yeah, we'll get bigger ones.
Yeah.
Just sharp little things. So it just shows me that your classes are good, you're spawning.
And lots of small fish, yeah.
Yeah, nice.
Yeah, nice
Go
to
on,
see.
Walleye. Beautiful.
Nice to see. Boom.
Good one?
Yeah, not bad.
You got them dialed in, my friend, there.
Oh, that's...
Boy, they're pushing the limit.
Yeah.
Close to eating size.
Oh, he's... You can't get any better than
okay.
50 than that.
Sounds
yeah,
good.
Yeah. Yeah.
Because we're allowed 4 each total, right?
Yes.
Yeah, man.
Yeah.
So that's actually 8 fillets. That's a lot.
You know, that's tasty.
Yeah, man.
Yeah.
That's the thing about going to a lodge, that people do share that camaraderie and what they're catching fish on. Pink, another one. Have some pink. Because sometimes guys are like, you have no pink? Pink rules. Another one with some orange and chartreuse. And obviously, I got some chartreuse with black contrast, like a little tiger. That's about 1/8 ounce, 3/16 ounce, and a good old quarters. You mix up a little bit of chartreuse, orange with black, and you're gonna catch walleyes just like us. Yeah, I can feel some grass and stuff on there. Feel good?
Well, that's a nice fisher.
Is it?
Yeah, it's nice. A nicer fish.
You let me know if you need to scoop him.
He's a netter.
Nice. I like hearing that.
As long as it's not a, oh no, it's a nice one. It's a nicer one.
It's a good eater one, eh?
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh, yeah, man.
Yeah.
Atta boy, Connor.
There we go.
Nice, man.
There we go.
Oh, yeah.
See, they're taking it, too.
It's got a little bit of color, that one,
yeah,
too, huh?
Yeah.
Beautiful, man. Gorgeous fish. Hey, what's the deal here, too? So if you get your four, you can keep fishing as long as
yeah,
you catch them.
Yeah, you can keep fishing. Yeah, you're just done okay. For your keepers
gotcha.
For the day. Yeah.
Gotcha.
Yeah.
There he is, right there.
There you go.
And he feels not bad.
Oh, yeah.
I think it's a walleye, too, man.
There we go.
Oh, yeah. Nice pick, too.
Oh, is that a St.Croix or a... You got a whitefish.
Come on.
Beautiful whitefish.
Really?
Beautiful whitefish.
Oh, wow,
yeah,
dude. I never caught one like that in the spring like that.
Yeah.
Wow.
Beautiful whitefish. And they fight.
The season's open?
Oh, yeah.
And how they taste?
Excellent.
Really?
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, and they fight
look
like
at them crap,
dude. Oh, they fight like a bass.
Wow.
Yeah, there you go. Oh, yeah.
Nice, man.
Beautiful whitefish.
Ah, you see, using the worm, I caught some whiteies. Whitefish, man, off my bucket list. I've caught them before on other lakes and stuff and vertical jigging and early spring and stuff like that, but never in a river situation where I'm thinking, those walleyes, look how fat they are. And you see how those things fight? Amazing, man. It's just a bonus when you can come up here and catch some secondary fish other than the targeted ones, like the walleyes. Get you some small northerns, maybe some big jumbo perch, but the whitefish, we're gonna have those for lunch. Yeah, right on, man.
There we go.
Show them a close up of that,
yeah.
Thing, Connor. I think that,
yeah.
Yeah, right on. Wow. I thought, what is that? Came to the top right away. Here's my rod of choice. I got the St. Croix Eyecon, and it's called the Jig and Rig. And it's 6'6", and it's a two-piece rod. So for you guys coming on planes, trains, and automobiles, and all kinds of things, it's real easy, right? So you got a two-piece rod, easy to transport, put it in baggage and stuff, or carry on, whatever you want. And you don't lose any of the sensitivity, feel, etc. You know, I'm using small jigs with light lines and things like that. And I'm just keeping it real simple, but I mean, it's, you still want to have something that has that feel of the light bite walleyes. Like even when they're aggressive sometimes, they just have that weird sponginess, like a leaf is on your line. And the Eyecon, it feels them every time. Come on, walleye. A couple back to back.
Yes.
Boom, boom.
In the sunshine.
Yes, look at that. Oh, it's changed again.
Mm-hmm.
Whoa!
Right where it was supposed to be. Ooh.
That's got it's a good fish wherever it is, Connor.
Okay, I got the net.
And I think it's Wally.
Be a Wally.
It is, it's a good one. Oh yeah, look, dude.
Oh nice. Beauty.
Eh?
There we go.
I had to put the sharpen on the blade, eh?
That was why.
I sharpened my sword.
Yeah.
Got him good?
Oh yeah, see that's a nice one.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Catching little small ones, like I say, sometimes you get delusional because it's like, and all of a sudden when you set and there's a little bit of meat, you know it, eh? Well, it's another eater, isn't it?
Oh, yeah.
We only came out, what time?
Find me one.
About 8:30, 9 o'clock, 9:30.
Yeah.
Had the wind, drizzle, rain, but you know what, Ontario, just be prepared for it. So what? You know, rain gear once in a while, we have to stop, put the jackets on, but we got a wind coming down like this funnel. It doesn't matter. We're catching fish. We're gonna have a fantastic shore lunch after. Back to the lodge, you know, watch some sports and just have a fantastic time. So if you wanna do it, Red Pine Lodge, right now on the screen, name, phone number, email, pick it up, call them, because you could do what we're doing right now. like fishing in a bathtub, eh?
Yeah.
Sitting back, pitching out in the edge. All of a sudden there's a weight or a little tick.
Yeah.
All I'm feeling is just a sensation.
Yes, me too.
The odd one
is
ticking. But
the first one really ticked it. That last pike did, obviously, but yeah. A little bit of weight and...
Yeah, it's amazing how good they can just inhale,
yes,
right?
Yes.
Without you even feeling it. Just a spongy little sensation.
There we go.
Size?
He's not bad. He's not bad.
He's staying down.
Actually, you know what? Yeah, he's better than... he's an eater.
Scooper?
No.
Boy, he's...
Yeah. He's a nice eater, though.
Oh, yeah, man.
Oh, yeah.
Yes.
See, more blue again, eh?
Yeah. Yeah. Got some blue walleye in there.
Yeah.
And those fins. Now, is it minnows? Is it worms? Is it leeches? Hey, we've got all three in our boat, even artificials. But why, you know, why fish hard? Really? You're up here at the lodge. You want to have fun. You want to catch some fish. You want to have a shore lunch. You want to share the memories. Use the meat. The minnows, the leeches, the worms. And as you see, Connor's getting all kinds of fish on the worms and the minnows. He likes the minnows because he's getting some good solid fish. I've got a few on the worm, and I got some whitefish, and hopefully I'll be able to tag a couple good more walleyes with my jig with the night crawler. Got one again?
You do.
You know what?
Oh, you got a nicer one.
Got a walleye?
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah. I can scoop it.
You got him? Oh, yeah, he's an eater.
Yeah, he's an eater. Huh?
He's an eater.
Yeah, man. I almost had another whitey there.
Yeah. Oh, look at that. Something got him.
Got attacked?
Ooh. Oh, yeah.
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 What do you think?
Oh, yeah, he's an eater.
Okay.
Oh, yeah.
Coming up to lodges like this, it's just so much fun, man. Really. And you're catching fish, and look, we're just in one spot. You can put the anchor down, use a boat from the lodge, go with a guide, then we go with Connor or somebody, and just sit on those fish and just have fun. Cast, drift, always new fish moving in. Fantastic experience, man. Ontario lodges, you gotta try it. Stick around, because we're gonna be right back.
Tucked beneath a hill covered with red pine trees is a spacious ranch-style building of Red Pine Lodge. This lodge has the perfect setting for a fishing or hunting trip of a lifetime, with room for large groups to enjoy the magic of Ontario's North Country. Red Pine Lodge is situated on the water's edge of Ivanhoe Lake, famous for some of the finest fishing in Northern Ontario for walleye, northern pike, whitefish, and jumbo perch. Red Pine Lodge also has three outpost camps for those that want total seclusion in the wilderness. As well, they also have two boat to outpost camps on the Ivanhoe River with access to the North Big Water. The comfortable cottages are on the waterfront and fully equipped with all amenities, which are considered luxury in such a remote northern location.
Good?
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Can you get this out of the way here?
Oh, he's nice. Yeah, he's nice. Yeah.
Oh, yeah, man. Yeah. I'll bet you dollars to donuts that's one you just saw.
Yeah.
And you just
that's
filled our
awesome.
Limit.
Awesome.
By calling
awesome.
Out.
Awesome. Look at that. He's a beaut.
Beautiful.
Yeah.
Saw him on the sonar.
Saw him on the screen and dropped to him. And
came back on the sandbar.
Yeah.
Fished exactly where it should be. So now we just gotta cull out one and we're good.
Look at that. Yeah.
That's how we're doing it at Red Pine Lodge, man. You wanna have some fun, you gotta come up here. Next part of the show, we are gonna have a shore lunch if he doesn't go back in.
Yeah, no, we got him, yeah. I'll hang on
and
tight.
Have some fun. Okay, here's the deal in Algoma Country. You allowed four walleyes, all under 18 inches, or three under 18 and one over 18. Now on this trip we didn't get any over 18, but seriously, how much can you eat? You know, we each got four fish. We're gonna have a shore lunch with the cameraman and the lodge owner and stuff like that. But man, that's a lot of meat. So when you come up to these lodges and stuff like that, Don't worry about those 5, 6, 7, 8, 10 pounders. They're fantastic if you catch them. Take some pictures, respect the resource, and let them live to create more of a generation for your friends and your family. But those fish that are in that 15, 16, 17, those are the yellow gold. Man, you talk about fun. Red Pine Lodge, he's got the houseboats, camps and stuff where we did the shore lunch. Pristine on the river, and it was just us. Saw a couple boats, but I mean, having that opportunity in the wilderness of Northern Ontario, it is just breathtaking. Seriously, we saw moose, bald eagles, all kinds of wildlife, but I mean, caught different species of fish. At the time of my life, man, I'll never forget it. You do it, I guarantee you, you'll never forget it. You come one time, you come back. You heard me say it. Just one time you come to Ontario, you will come back. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time right here on another lodge, another location, and another bucket list place that I'm sure that you'll want to come to after you see me catch them, release them, and eat them. Thanks for watching.
Experience Ontario's beautiful wilderness at Red Pine Lodge. Visit them at redpinelodge.com or call 877-264-4911 or 705-899-2875 to book your next Northern Ontario fishing adventure. The Xtreme Walleye Angler has been presented by Go Fishing Ontario. It's catching. St. Croix Rods, best rods on earth. Catch us at fishxtreme.com. Watch us, like us, follow us, see us.